Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Hany Ismail from Planning Engineer website. In this video, we are going to see the B6 layout and we are going to create a small project. So let's have a quick tour about B6. We'll check the B6 Primavera layout. I know that this course is related to project management fundamentals, but even if you are a project manager or construction manager, you need to know how to open and deal with Primavera schedules. I would like to tell you how to create a very simple schedule because you might need to do so. And also, if you received any schedule from your colleagues or from your contractor, I need you to be able to open and review it. So Primavera schedule or Primavera software is very simple. We have, like any other software, we have some menus. This menus we will be using, and I will not tell you what each menu will do until we need it. So quickly, we have this top menu, okay, where we can find the file, edit, view, project. Like any other software, you have the above menu. Then you have here this side menu. In the side menu, you can create a new project, you can see the resources and so on. All I need from you now is to know where are the locations of these menus. That's it. Also, we have some menus here. It is like a tab where we can shift between projects and activities. And the last menu, you can see here that we can add some activities or WBS or whatever. You will be easy using it while we are creating our small schedule. Now we have this area. This is the activities area where we can add activities, prepare our WBS and so on. And this area is a bar chart where we can see the Gantt chart for our activities. Also, we have here a detailed window where we can add some more information or more resources to our activities. So don't worry, I don't need you to remember any of these menus. Just I let you know the component of the Primavera software. To access project in your database, simply from projects, from enterprise menu, you can see all your projects here. So from enterprise, you can find projects. Let me show you in my Primavera where I can find my projects. Once I install the Primavera, you might have some already preloaded projects or whatever projects you have here. So we have here these two tabs. This is the activities of the open project and these are the project. You can go from them simply like this. But if you don't have this one, you can simply go to the enterprise, then go to the projects. It will give you to the same window where you can find all your projects. Of course, I know that you are very smart to notice that this you can expand or collapse a project for using minus and the plus signs. So if you have a EPS, in that case, enterprise project structure, which some kind of sorting your projects under one main title, so you can open and close from using minus and the plus signs. Let me show you also. So here I have some project in Saudi Arabia. I can expand or collapse. I can open like this, expand or collapse. So it's very simple. Let's create a simple time schedule in Primavera P6. How difficult it is. But before going to it, let me tell you what are the inputs and what are the expected outputs. So here, in order to create a time schedule, we need a contract. We need bill of quantities and we need drawings. And we'll explain why we need these documents in a minute. We are expecting to have cost loading sheets, time schedule, XAR, PDFs, cash flow, resource loading sheets. I'm not going to create all of them, but I'm telling you what you should expect when you are creating a time schedule. What we need from the contract. In order to create a time schedule, you need to know who are the stakeholders, what is the project scope for, what are the main dates, total cost, milestones. Milestones here mean important dates like the project start date, finish date, if you have some intermediate dates. All of these you need to know before starting your time schedule. Okay, so what we need from the bill of quantity of or BOQ? We need to know the price of each item, detailed material information, notes for quantity distribution. We can create the activity database and then create cost loading sheet. This is something very specific for plannings. And we are not going to study in this course, but I'm giving you the overall picture so you know what is going on. So why we need the drawing? We need to read the drawings to understand the distribution of areas. I might have one room which has some certain activities, but another room or another floor, there are no similar activities. So when I'm creating my time schedule, I need to know which activities I should put in each floor or area. Also, I will need the drawings to identify specific finishes places. Now we knew the decomments or inputs we need, let's discuss the steps required to create time schedule. In order to create time schedule, we will create WBS. We can start doing it outside Primavera. Why? Because we might need to discuss with the project team how we are going to decompose our project. We are going to use phases, we are going to use areas, which buildings will start first. So this will impact how you are going to organize your project under WBS. I'm going to tell you more information about WBS in a minute. But once we agreed about the WBS we would like to use, then we'll create it in Primavera. Then you'll use BOQ to create data loading sheet, then create the cost loading sheet, add the activities to Primavera, then create material and shop drawing activities. Once we created this one, then we can start modifying the durations and relationships between activities, add cost, and extract the project cash flow. We still missing one step, is to calculate the activity resources, add resources to Primavera P6, then we can extract resources histograms and export and print. In our course, we are going to discuss some points in practical, so I'm going to do it in front of you, like creating WBS in P6, activities in P6, relationships in P6, durations in P6, export, import, and print from P6. So I think these are the fundamental skills you need to learn. However, there are other things I'm going to give you more information about it, but I'm not going to do it in practical in front of you because we have other courses covering these areas. And also, to be honest, not everyone might be interested to know exactly how to do these things. So WBS, duration estimation, cost and resource loading, cash flow histograms, material and shop drawings, we are going to discuss the concept, but we are not going to do it in practical. So let's add a new project and see how simple it is. To create a new project, click on new or add, as simple as this. So let's say I would like to add a new project. I simply click add new, and then the Primavera will ask me where you would like to save your project. Then I will select the EPS or enterprise project structure, which is very simple organization that I can see here. Let's say I will put it here, then I'll click next and finish. Now here I have a new project which was created here, very simple. So as we discussed that after clicking new, we'll select the EPS and then we have our project created. You can name your project or rename it. Let's rename our project to be my first project. The project should have ID and name. I'll let the ID to be Hany, and the project name, I will name it my first project. So simply, I can double click here the ID and rename it Hany. And here also, I can double click and rename it my first project. Very simple. Now our project is ready. How to open it? Let's say we closed our Primavera and we need to open it again and open our project. Very simple. In order to open any project, just right click and open project. That's it. After we opening the project, it should look empty. Now we can create the WBS or work breakdown structure that has the name of our project. Before creating the WBS or work breakdown structure in Primavera, let us talk a little bit about the WBS. WBS, let's say we are going to construct house. Can we manage constructing a house without decomposing the activities of the house into excavation, concrete, then drawings, then masonry work, paint, and so on? So we make our WBS in order to be able to manage the individual tasks. If you say, okay, I would like to build a house, and that's it, you cannot manage. You cannot find out whether you are ahead or behind because it is a very big scope of work you cannot manage. By doing WBS, we are breaking down the scope of work into smaller, achievable, and related work packages. Like here, building a house, this is a level 0 of WBS. Level 1 will be civil works architectural works, MEP works. Under level 1, we'll have level 2. Under civil work, we can have substructure, superstructure. Under architectural work, we'll have rough finishes, final finishes, and so on. Under the latest WBS, we can add our activities. So creating a small schedule WBS, what we are doing now, will give us the opportunity to talk about good WBS and bad WBS. The good WBS will capture all project work. Tasks are broken down to a manageable level. Use clear and concise language. Tasks directly support the project goals and deliverables. However, the bad WBS will be missing important tasks. Tasks are too broad or general, contains confusing terms leading to misunderstanding, or tasks are not aligned with the project objectives leading to wasted efforts. The first step in creating work breakdown structure is to start decomposing the scope of work that you have into smaller packages. These packages will be decomposed again into activities. And here, from the best practices in planning, you should discuss with the project team, the owner of the project, the consultant, the contractor, subcontractors, whoever is important, how we are going to construct the project. You might decide to have different, as I said before, different zones, different areas. So it is better to know it at the beginning. Coming back to our Primavera, how to create WBS? Very simple. Go to project WBS. Let's see it on action. And we can add WBS from this button. So simply we will go here from project WBS, then we can start adding our WBS from here. You can see this one, you can add it. Very simple, very easy. Okay, now we would like to add another WBS because we would like to build a hierarchy. We need to create phase 1 and phase 2 to be in the same level. Okay, and in order to have something like this, so we'll have here, this is the project, my first project. Then under this one, we should have phase 1 and phase 2. Let's see how to do it. So simply this one, I'll call it phase 1. Now I need to add a new level and I will call it phase 2. But if you notice that the phase 1 is under phase 2, I don't want it like this. I need them to be in the same level. As you can see here, these arrows will control the level of your WBS. So simply I'm going to go one level back. So phase 1 and phase 2 will be in the same level. Now if I go to the activities, I can see still level 1 and level 2 not in the same level. Can press F5 to refresh the database. Now you can see that I have the project, then level 1 and level 2. If you can see the previous screen in your case, just press F5. So this is before I press F5, it should be like this. After I press F5, it will be like this. Now try doing these steps by yourself and I think you will find it very useful and very easy. You will have the PDF file to download it and see the steps. I hope you will find this video useful to you. See you in the next one.